Hi students, in the previous videos we discussed what is photoelectric effect, what is the effect of external potential, what is the effect of intensity, frequency of light on photoelectric current, and also we discussed what is the famous Einstein's photoelectric effect equation and how did Einstein solve the problem of wave optics, which was not able to, or wave theory, which was not able to explain photoelectric effect, how Einstein solved it using his famous equation. Now, in this video, we are going to discuss about dual nature of matter. Dual nature means matter having two nature. So, before going into that topic, let us see what do you mean by dual nature of radiation or dual nature of light. Now, in the chapter of optics, we have studied the phenomena like interference, diffraction and polarization. Now, all these phenomena of light were explained using the wave nature of light. He is considering light as a wave. Now, in this chapter, we discussed photoelectric effect. And we found that using wave theory or using the wave concept of light, we cannot explain photoelectric effect. It was explained using the particle nature of light, which we call the photons. Now, one more effect is there known as the Compton effect, which was also explained by the scientists using the particle nature of light, which means depending upon situations, light sometimes shows the properties of a wave or sometimes it shows the property of a particle. That is what we mean by dual nature of radiation. Light as an electromagnetic ray is showing the property of both the particle and the property of wave depending on the situation. Dual nature of radiation or dual nature of light. Now, let us see what do we mean by dual nature of matter. How can matter show both the nature? In 1924, a famous physicist in French, from France, known by the name Louis de Broglie, it is actually pronounced as de Broglie, it is not Louis de Broglie, it is the French name, but we say as de Broglie. So, in 1924, de Broglie put forward a very bold hypothesis, a very bold suggestion without any experimental evidence, that if light can show the dual nature, that if light can show the property of a particle and a wave, then matter in motion will display wave nature. That means particles which are moving with a very high speed will show the property of a wave. This was a very bold hypothesis put forward by de Broglie. Okay, and for this bold hypothesis or for considering matter as a wave, he was awarded Nobel Prize in 1929. Now, for the reason he said that matter shows the property of wave while in motion is based on the fact that he said in nature there is symmetry. Nature was symmetrical. If the physical quantities like energy and matter have symmetry, then definitely matter can show the property of a particle and a wave. And the wave associated with the matter in motion, the wave associated with matter like electron, proton, neutron, etc. in motion is known by the name matter waves, or it is also known as de Broglie waves. matter waves or de Broglie waves. So if there is a wave, definitely it will be having a wavelength, and the wavelength of the wave is known as de Broglie wavelength. A very important question for your board exam: what is de Broglie wavelength? The wavelength of matter wave is what we call de Broglie wavelength. And this was a very bold hypothesis put forward by Louis de Broglie, that is Louis de Broglie, in 1924. Now let us derive the equation for de Broglie wavelength, and this equation is known by the name de Broglie wave equation. Okay, for that first we consider the case of electromagnetic wave, that is light. Now considering light or radiation as a wave of frequency nu using Planck's quantum theory, the energy of the wave is given as E is equal to h nu. Now next we consider the concept as of light as a particle. So considering radiation as a particle of mass m moving with a velocity v using Einstein's famous mass energy equation, you can write using Einstein mass energy relation. What is the relation? What is the equation? E equal to mc square. So equation 2. So both these equations represents the energy of light. So we can compare the equation equation 1 and 2 and write mc square is equal to h nu. Next what we are going to do is we are going to convert nu, that is frequency, in terms of velocity and wavelength. So this can be written as h c divided by lambda. Okay, made a small mistake. Considering radiation as a particle of mass m and velocity, it is not v, it is c. Okay, we get E equal to mc square. The equation becomes mc square is equal to hc by lambda, or wavelength lambda is equal to h divided by mc, which can be written as h divided by p, momentum of the photon. Now Louis de Broglie said if this is the wavelength of the light, then which shows the property of both the particle and wave, then a particle such as electron, proton, neutron moving with the velocity v has a wavelength equal to lambda is equal to h divided by mv, which is equal to h divided by p. Now, this is an equation which relates the wave nature with the particle nature, because lambda is a term related to wave and momentum is a term related to particle nature. So, this is a famous Louis de Broglie equation which relates the wavelength to the momentum of the particle. I hope you are clear with the derivation. For we considered, for this derivation we considered two equations. One is considering light as a wave, we got E is equal to h nu. Considering light as a particle, we got E is equal to mc square. Compared, we got h lambda is equal to h divided by mc. Then what did Louis de Broglie said? He said, if light has dual nature, definitely matter is also having dual nature. And for a particle which is moving with the velocity v, having mass m, the wavelength of the matter wave is lambda is equal to h divided by p. This is the famous Louis de Broglie equation. The wave equation. Next, we are going to write the wavelength in terms of kinetic energy. So, of an electron, we are going to find out the equation of wavelength of an electron moving with the velocity v in terms of kinetic energy. It is a very simple derivation. For that, let us consider an electron of mass m moving with a velocity v. Then kinetic energy of the electron is given by half m v square, which we can write it as k. Kinetic energy is represented by the letter, capital letter k. Or velocity v from this above equation is root of 2 k divided by m. So, we got the velocity of the electron. Now, substituting this value of velocity in de Broglie equation, and what is de Broglie equation? It is lambda is equal to h divided by mv, which will be now written as h divided by m into root of 2k by m. M can be written as root m into root m. So, the equation becomes h divided by root of 2mk. This is the equation for de Broglie wavelength of an electron in terms of kinetic energy. And what is the equation? Lambda is equal to h divided by root of 2mk. Next, there is one more derivation. You will be asked to find out what is the de Broglie wavelength in terms of accelerating potential, or you will be asked to prove de Broglie wavelength lambda is equal to 12.3 divided by root capital V, that is external potential Angstrom unit. This is a very important question for your board exam. Either they will be asked derive the expression of wavelength, de Broglie wavelength in terms of accelerating potential V, or you will be asked to derive an expression for wavelength as 12.3 divided by root V Angstrom unit. Okay, for this, same as the previous derivation, we will consider an electron of mass m. Let the electron be initially at rest and it be connected to an external potential v, which accelerates the electron, and the final velocity of the electron becomes capital small letter v. Now, the work done by the potential is given by, you have studied this in electrostatic, work done by potential is given by work done on the electron by the potential is given by E capital letter V, where E is the charge of the electron. So, work done by the potential on the electron is E V. Now, when we are doing work, what happens? There will be change in kinetic energy, and that change in kinetic energy is actually final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy. Here we have assumed that the electron was at rest initially, so U equal to 0. So, change in kinetic energy is equal to what? Half m v square. So, whatever work I am doing, it produces a kinetic energy of half m v square. So, we can equate both this equation, isn't it? So, I am right. Work done on the electron is equal to change in kinetic energy. That is, E capital V is equal to half m v square, or we can write velocity V is equal to root of 2 E V capital V divided by m. Now, applying the value of velocity in the equation of de Broglie wavelength. Lambda is equal to h divided by m v, which can be written as h divided by m into root of 2 e v divided by m. That is h divided by root of 2 m e v. Okay. Next, what we are going to do is we are going to substitute the values, the known values, to this equation. We know h is the Planck's constant, and what is the value of Planck's constant? Value of Planck's constant is h is equal to 6.63 into 10 raised to minus 34 joule second. M is the mass of the electron. What is the value? 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 31 kilogram. E is the charge of the electron. Value is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. So, on substituting all these values to the above equation, we get lambda is equal to 12.3 divided by root V, capital letter V, that is potential angstrom. So, very simple derivation, but an important question for your board exam. Okay, we just found out the work done by the external potential on the electron, it is E V, and that potential brings what? Change to the kinetic energy, that is half m v square. We compared both the equations. We got the equation as V is equal to h divided by root of 2 m e capital letter V. We substituted the values for h, m and e, and we got the final answer as de Broglie wavelength of the electron as lambda is equal to 12.3 angstrom unit divided by capital letter root of capital letter V. I hope this derivation is clear to you. Thank you.